पूरा टिकोरा दोगा अलग।
ಹಲೋ, ಹಾ ಮೇಡಮ್, ನಿಮ್ದು ಇಮೇಲ್ ಐ ಡಿನ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಿಮ್ದು ಮೇಲ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಯೂಸರ್ ಐ ಡಿ ಪಾಸ್ವರ್ಡ್ ನೋಡಿ. ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಹೌದು 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 ಹೌದು. ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು ನನಗೆ. ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅದ್ರ ಸಲುವಾಗಿ ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು, ಅದ್ರ ಸಲುವಾಗಿ ನಾನೇ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಕಳಿಸಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇದ್ರಾಗಂತೂ ಹಾಕ್ತಿದ್ದೀವಿ, ಇದ್ರಾಗಂತೂ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ನೋಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹಾಕ್ತಿದೆ. ಅದು ಮಾಡಿ, ಅದು ಮಾಡ್ರಿ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅದು ಗೂಗಲ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಂತ ಏನಿದೆ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವಾಗ ಟೈಮ್ ಸಿಕ್ಕಾಗ ಅವಾಗ ಅದ ಏನ ಮಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಇರ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಂತ. ಅದು ನಾ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅದು. ಆಯ್ತು, ನಿಮ್ದು ಆ್ಯಡ್
ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಹಲೋ ಹಲೋ, ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ.
Good morning, ma'am.
So today I'll be starting with this comparator, zero crossing detector, Schmitt trigger, and D2A converter. Hello. Now, sir, comparator is used for comparing two voltage signals by using op amp. Okay, now depending upon which voltage you are comparing with the input, it can be used as either zero crossing detector or voltage level detector. First we will understand the zero crossing detector. Now at the very first glance, in case of comparator, since it is open loop configuration of op amp, the output will be either plus Psat or minus Psat, that is positive saturation voltage level or negative saturation voltage level. Now depending upon whether the input difference voltage is positive or negative, we all know that the comparator, so input is V1 minus V2, where V1 is the voltage applied at non-inverting terminal and V2 is the voltage applied at inverting terminal. If this difference voltage is positive, then output will be positive saturation voltage level, and if this difference voltage is negative, then output will be negative saturation voltage, and this plus or minus Psat is dependent upon the supply voltage. Usually it is 1 volt and the supply voltage. So at all times output will be either plus Psat or minus Psat. Now zero crossing detector is whenever the input crosses the zero line, that time output has to switch over from plus Psat to minus Psat. Now here we can see, since input is connected to non-inverting pin, here if it is positive, output will be plus Psat, means this voltage is compared with 0 volts. Since this voltage is greater than 0 volts, output is saturated in the positive side here. So that is plus Psat. Now this will happen until the input will be below 0 volts, that is when it starts its negative half cycle. Now the moment input becomes negative, that is less than 0 volts, that time output will be switched to minus VSAT level. The at the zero crossing of the input, output is switching from plus VSAT to minus VSAT. That is why it is known as zero crossing detector. Now its summary is given here. Here difference voltage is nothing but V input minus V reference. Whenever difference voltage is greater than 0 volts, output is equal to plus VSAT. And whenever difference voltage is less than 0 volts, output voltage is equal to minus VSAT. Now suppose if we want to detect some other voltage level other than 0 volts, so that time we are having voltage level detector. Now that is decided by a reference voltage applied at an inverting pin. Yeah, so the circuit diagram will be shown like this. So there are two possibilities for non-zero voltage level detection. In one simple method, we can use voltage divider circuit in order to derive the voltage V reference at inverting pin. So what is the voltage at inverting pin in this case? It is simply the drop developed across this resistor, that is R2 resistor. Now total voltage is V into R2 divided by R1 plus R2 will be the reference voltage. So we have shown the same thing. So V into R2 divided by R1 plus R2 is the reference voltage. Yeah. So the input is now compared with this reference voltage. Now suppose if input is greater than the reference voltage, what will happen? Non-inverting input voltage is greater than inverting terminal voltage, therefore output will be plus VSAT. And whenever this voltage is less than this reference voltage, output will be minus VSAT. So that is how it will function. So the so the function is shown here. So here difference voltage is equal to V in minus V reference. Whenever this difference voltage is greater than 0 volts, output equal to plus VSAT. And when V in is less than V reference or difference voltage is less than 0 volts, the same output voltage equal to minus VSAT. And if I am using a Zener diode as shown in this particular slide here, so the second option is to use a Zener diode. So Zener diode, we all know that it will have a particular breakdown voltage and that is used as a reference voltage. And if the breakdown voltage, for example 10 volts here, then reference voltage is 10 volts. So at inverting pin, whatever breakdown voltage of the Zener diode is there, that is considered. So this voltage level is detected by this particular circuit. Okay. So how it will work? Now here, see difference voltage in this case is V in minus VZ. So when difference voltage is greater than 0 volts, output is saturated to positive level. And when difference voltage is less than 0 volts, it is equal to minus VSAT. So that is how it will work. Now let us take an example for this comparator. Yeah. Now suppose we want to detect the voltage decided by this voltage divider here at inverting pin. Yeah. So we have to draw the output waveform corresponding to this circuit. Yeah. So supply voltage is 15 volts, R1 resistor is 8.2 kilo ohms, R2 is 10 kilo ohms. Now how we are going to obtain the waveform for this? Very simple. We have to first find out the reference voltage, which is nothing but the drop developed across R2 resistor. So R2 into plus V divided by R1 plus R2. Now substituting these values, we get the reference voltage as 1.63 volts. So 1.63 volts is positive voltage. So this is my input waveform. Yeah. So here is my, what is this noise? Huh? Hello? So this is 1.3 volts voltage reference level. Here, now your input is compared with this reference voltage. Now, whenever this input is greater than this reference voltage, since it is non-inverting configuration, output will be plus Vsat. Whenever input voltage is less than this reference voltage, that time output will be at minus Vsat. So we draw the waveforms like this. So these are the levels where output is switching from plus Vsat to minus Vsat. Now coming to Schmitt trigger. Now what is the drawback of this zero crossing detector or comparator? So suppose if the input is added with some noise, that time it will have multiple triggering levels. That means what? If input noise which is added exceeds the reference voltage level, that time output will be switching between plus Vsat and minus Vsat. And this problem will be avoided by using the Schmitt trigger. So it will because of its feedback used at the non-inverting pin. Yeah. So it will avoid multiple triggerings which are appearing in the comparator. So this is one advantage of Schmitt trigger. And also we are using feedback that will deal the noise better than the comparator. And this is the hysteresis curve for Schmitt trigger depending upon where is the triggering. Here, whether it is upper threshold level or lower threshold level. Here, where switching over from plus Vsat to minus Vsat and minus Vsat to plus Vsat takes place. Here. Now here. Now here, suppose output is plus 10 volts in this particular circuit. Suppose output is plus 10 volts. Now what will happen? A portion of this output gets developed across resistor R1. Yeah. And if I assume this as 1 volt, unless this input voltage exceeds 1 volt, output will not change its level from minus Vsat to plus Vsat. Yeah. So output will not change until this input exceeds this reference voltage, which is nothing but in this case feedback voltage developed across R1 resistor. Similarly, if output is say minus 10 volts, that is minus Vsat, that time we just assume that a drop developed across this R1 resistor is minus 1 volt. Yeah, then input will not change as long as input is not below minus 1 volt, output will not change its level. Yeah. So it has to drop below minus 1 volt, only then output will change its triggering level. So that is what is explained in this particular circuit. Now here, these voltages at which output is switching from plus Vsat to minus Vsat and minus Vsat to plus Vsat are known as threshold points. Here, that is upper threshold point and lower threshold point, UTP and LTP. And difference between these two voltage levels is known as hysteresis. Difference between these two is known as hysteresis. So, the equations for these, here, whatever I just explained, it is now given here. Now, suppose output is plus Vsat, whatever drop developed across R1 resistor will give you upper threshold point or upper threshold voltage level. So, VUT equal to R1 into plus Vsat divided by R1 plus R2. We are using voltage divider rule in this case. Similarly, when output is minus Vsat, whatever drop is developed across R1 resistor, that will give me lower threshold point or lower threshold voltage is simply equal to R1 into minus Vsat divided by R1 plus R2. So the difference between UTP and LTP will give me hysteresis voltage. That is V hysteresis equal to VUT minus VLT. Now suppose if we are desiring different UTP and LTP, then we can use a reference voltage at this point. See, in the previous circuit, here we had 0 as the reference level here. So, one end of this R1 is directly connected to ground. That is why we could take the drop developed across R1 as the feedback voltage or reference voltage, which is compared with the input voltage. Whereas in this circuit, we have V reference also. So, one end of this is derived from this output voltage. So, difference between these two is the drop developed across R2 resistor, clear, which is now compared with your input voltage. So, in this case, if V input is greater than this equation is given, clear, which is derived from these two conditions, clear, positive ongoing transition or negative ongoing transition, depending upon whether output is plus V sat or minus V sat, clear. So, accordingly, we have these two levels here. So, that is upper threshold point and lower threshold point. So, this we have already done in laboratory also. These equations, you know how we have derived the equations for R1, R2 resistors here using a given hysteresis. Now see, I just showed you the case where we had connected the input at non-inverting terminal. Yeah. So here, input at inverting terminal was connected. Clear. So this is inverting Schmitt trigger. So there is one more possibility where we can connect the input to non-inverting terminal as shown in this figure. Here, this is not there for your syllabus, but you should have an idea about there is another configuration also which will give me the Schmitt trigger circuit. Here, so where we are connecting the external source to non-inverting terminal. So, for just information sake, I have added this particular slide. Here, so non-inverting Schmitt trigger is also possible. Here. Now the advantage, this I have already explained, no? Transition time, due to the positive feedback Schmitt trigger, the transition time of the output is very fast. So these things I have already explained you. So next comes A to D converter and D to A converter. First I will take D to A converter, that is digital to analog conversion. So in many applications, here we need to convert the digital input into corresponding analog output voltage. So first we have to understand what is analog information here. So in analog information means what? Continuously varying with respect to time, as we have shown in this particular waveform here. Here the signal is varying continuously with respect to time, whereas digital signal is what? Here we at discrete instants of time, here the value of this signal will be changing. Here, so we have discrete voltage levels in case of digital signal. Here, so in most of the cases, we need to convert this digital info into analog corresponding analog waveform. For that, we are using D to A signal. Here, suppose we have a bit pattern and we want to know what is the corresponding analog signal. So for that we have to use this D to A conversion. Now general block diagram of D to A conversion, it will have n inputs here and one output here, only one output, that is analog output here. Here it is shown better. Now suppose we have 8 inputs and one output here. So 8 input and one output, similar to your MUX, but not, it is not MUX. Okay, so here this is binary input and the corresponding analog output voltage will be produced. Now what is the resolution of this D to A converter? Now suppose I have n bits in the input pattern. With n bits, total number of patterns possible are 2 raised to n here, and the counting starts from 0. That is why the last number which is counted with n bits will be 2 raised to n minus 1. So if I want to find out the resolution of this DAC, then it will be equal to 1 divided by 2 raised to n minus 1. Clear? The number of steps that it can take. Clear? So that is 1 divided by 2 raised to n minus 1. Larger the n, better will be DAC, and smaller will be the step size. Clear? That is the thing. Clear? So larger the n value, better will be the resolution of the DAC. Clear? So here step size is given as V reference divided by 2 raised to n minus 1. Clear? So suppose if n equal to 4, so we have total how many counts? 256. Okay, 256 minus 1 will give you 255. So V reference divided by 255 will be the step size. Here, so here we have shown it for n equal to 12. So the resolution is 244. Here, 0.0244% here parts per million. Now how it is exactly designed? Clear? So we have two cases. One is known as weighted resistor circuit. Here, in case of weighted resistor DAC, here the DACs are taken in such a way that each value is expressed as power of 2. Here, so first resistor is 2 raised to 1 R. Second resistor is 2 raised to 2 R. 2 raised to 3 R. In general, it is 2 raised to N R. Here, so the first bit here, which will operate on this switch, if this bit is 1, clear, then it is connected to this VR. Clear, if bit is 0, then it is connected to ground. Clear, so this bit is your most significant bit. You have to remember in such a way that most significant bit always correspond to very least resistance value in the circuit. How to identify MSB and LSB is challenging. Clear, so you just remember that wherever we have used the smallest resistor value, the corresponding bit is most significant bit. And wherever we have used the largest resistance value, that bit is least significant bit. Yeah. So here in this case, we are writing B1, B2, B3, B4. Yeah. So here it is B1, B2, B3 up to Bn, where Bn is least significant bit. See, in your textbook, he has started from B0. So B0 is taken as most significant bit. So B0, B1, B2, B3 he has taken. B3 is least significant bit. So that is how you remember. Now, how to derive the expression for the output voltage? What we are doing, we are using virtual ground concept here. So we all know that according to virtual ground concept, the voltage at inverting pin is equal to voltage at non-inverting pin. Voltage at non-inverting pin. Since non-inverting pin is connected to ground, here voltage at this node is also at ground. Here, therefore, we can directly apply the KCL at this particular junction. Sum of all the incoming currents is now equal to sum of all the outgoing currents. Here, so here I1 plus I2 plus I3 up to IN is equal to I, because bias current or base current is negligible, which is going into input of this op amp because of very large gain and large input resistance. Here, therefore, what we have is I equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3 up to IN. Now you substitute for I1, I2, I3. Clear? So I1 is the current flowing through that first resistor here, which had 2 raised to 1 into R value. Now second resistor we had 2 raised to 2 into R value. The corresponding voltage is VR. Clear? Reference voltage. Now depending upon whether the corresponding bit is 0 or 1, the value will be contributed. If it is 0, this value will be 0. Clear? If it is 1 only, then this much voltage is added to the total voltage. Clear? That is how it is obtained. Clear? So all these bits will decide whether the corresponding voltage contribution is there or not. Clear? So accordingly, we get the expression for output as V0 equal to VR into B1 2 raised to minus 1, B2 2 raised to minus 2, B2. This we have already used in the laboratory also. You have done the experiment on this and how various step size or staircase waveform is generated and displayed on the CRO that we have seen. Correct. So two examples I have shown here. They are corresponding to two bit patterns. First one is 001 and second one is 101. In case of 001, output voltage is equal to VR divided by 8, and in second case, V naught is equal to minus 5 VR divided by 8. Yeah. Is there any doubt? Hello? Hello? Hello, is there any doubt in this? Whatever I have covered so far?
No, ma'am.
One second, I will take attendance. What's the gap here? Hello, don't go. Okay, I'm taking attendance. Priorities nahi the darwaza khala zara. Priorities nahi wo hai. కుటపర్యంత అమోఘ హెచ్ఆర్లు అమోఘ హెచ్ఆర్ కుట అమోఘ పిఆర్
Yes, ma'am.
One second. I'm taking photo itself. Last one now, Jai Hind. Hello. Now the various applications of digital to analog converter I have shown here. Yeah, so it is used for voltage controlled amplifier, then a digitally operated attenuator, programmable filter, and CD players use this, MP3 players and telephone. And other applications are digital oscilloscopes, then signal generators. Here, so these also use DAC. And other applications involve motor controllers like cruise controller and valve control or motor control. If you have any doubts, you can ask. Hello?
No, ma'am, no doubts.
No, ma'am, no doubts.
Thank you for attending, okay?
Thank you, ma'am.